primary activities where we directly extract the natural resources for human consumption, like agriculture and allied activities. They are the primary activities which provide maximum employment, or this which is the largest mode of survival for mankind. That is the primary activities. And then the secondary activities where primary resources are utilized, processed, and after value addition we supply them to the market, to the people. So basically producing the raw material into the finished industrial product, that is called secondary activities. And after secondary activities, let's switch over to the next topic, that is the tertiary activities. And in tertiary activities, basically it is linked with the secondary activities. Higher the level of secondary activities, higher the trade, and the level of development also determine. More the development, more the tertiary activities. So here important tertiary activities are basically transport and trade. Basically trade control the transport. I should write vice versa, but your syllabus, as per your syllabus, it is transport and trade and services. So these are the three activities which are called tertiary activities. Let's discuss the transport first. Transport is, what are the different modes of transport? Modes of transport may be pedal chalte hain, we walk, we transport the goods. We use bicycle, we use two-wheeler, we use three-wheeler, we use four-wheeler, we use multi-vehicle, we use with increasing distance we change the modes of transportation. So modes of transportation changes with the distance factor and on the basis of level of development. Modes are basically surface transport. Surface transport means it is the road transport. Roads are the different types of roads. Like in India, the road transport authority divided the roads into four different types of roads. One is the national highway, second is the state highway, third is the district roads, fourth is the village roads. So national highway, state highway, district, national highways are maintained by the National Highway Authority of India. They are long distance, connecting the ports and the capitals to the interior of the country. So in India we have almost 30 lakh kilometer road length. Out of this, national highways are only 4% to the total length. Only 4%, and national highways are transporting 80% of the total freight weight and almost 2/3 passenger on the of the country. So national highways are only 4%, but they are catering the service to the largest goods and the largest population. So we have the different types of roads, like national highway, NH, SH, state highway, district roads. In India we have the different nomenclature. So in the all over the world, auto vahan, like national highway, national, the different name are there in used for the national highways in the world, like auto vahan. It is in Germany. There is a different name in France, different name in US, different name in Australia, different name in England. But I'm just, and the village roads. You know, village roads, they are connecting. They are basically unmetalled road. They are rather seasonal road. They are not all weather road. They connect one village to another. They may be metalled, they may not be metalled, they may be pebbled, they may be undulated. So they are basically for the bullock carts, for the local people, and they are also used for localized agriculture machinery. Apart from that, in the national highways we have the express roads. Express roads are basically express. Then we have the superways. Expressways and the superways we have converted to increase the speed, uninterrupted speed, by constructing the bypasses, making the flyovers, removing all the obstacles from the road. We converted national highways into the faster routes. So we have like Bombay-Pune expressway, Mysore-Bangalore expressway, or you can say Delhi-Jaipur expressway. So that is, and the superways. Superways are basically for long distance, uninterrupted movement. They are mostly highways. We have constructed Golden Quadrilateral. We connected North-South Corridor, East-West Corridor. Apart from that, we have the international highways. So international highways are, international highways. International highways are like from India to Tibet. From Simla to Sipkila, it goes all the way to Tibet to Lhasa. That is Indo-Tibetan International Highway. One road from Imphal to Moray and Moray to Myanmar. You can say Mandalay in Myanmar. So that is International Highway. They are connecting, like nowadays China is making the belt, the connecting Pakistan and providing through the Karakoram Pass, which is highly objectionable for India. India, because Karakoram is the part of Indian jurisdiction. So international highways, they are playing vital role. You know, if I construct a small map of say USA and South America, so you know Alaska here. From Alaska, all the way there is a highway passes through like this, over the Andes, and it goes up to the Santiago in the south. So this is Pan-American Highway, longest highway in the world, connecting Fairbanks from Alaska, Alaska to all the way to Vancouver, and Vancouver to California, you know, say Seattle, San Francisco, Los Angeles, and it comes all the to the isthmus to this, all it touches many capitals and reached up to the southernmost capital in South America, and south of Santiago also in Chile. So this is Pan-American Highway. There are the other roads. These are the Great Lakes. So lakes are there. There is a road connecting like this. This is Pan Canadian Highway. Since this is the Rockies Mountains, from here to here, you know, Chicago is here. From Chicago to New York, or from straight to the New York. This is Pan American Highway connecting Pacific Coast to the Atlantic Coast. And this is again in Canada. This is Pan Canada, Trans-Canadian Highway. So these are the Trans-Canadian Highway, Trans-American Highway, Pan-American Highway. So in India also, you know, the GT Road, Grand Trunk Road, it was feeding the Central Asia from Arabian Sea. From Kolkata to Delhi, and Delhi to Lahore to Peshawar, and passing through the Khyber Pass to Kabul, and it was going all the way up to Tashkent. So up to Central Asia, that was the purpose of this highway. So highways are international highways. They are passing through many countries. So the main reason for the development of Europe is they have the dense network of the road transport. So density of road determines, the density of road means length of road per square kilometer. Length of the road available, and there is one intensity of road, but for roads we are not using. Thing is, per capita availability of road, though it is very confusing nomenclature. If I say per capita availability of road, Arunachal Pradesh is having the highest per capita availability of road. But if you say per square kilometer road, Arunachal Pradesh is having the lowest per square kilometer of road because it is mountainous, rugged, inaccessible road, population is very sparse. So such nomenclature sometimes confuse the per capita availability and per square kilometer length of the road. But more important is per square kilometer availability of road is more important. So these are the different type of the national, and you know, in Australia, Trans-Australian Highway connecting Perth to Canberra through Adelaide and up to Melbourne and this. So if I consider this is in Australia, it is like this. So this is the Perth here, from Perth to say it is the Melbourne broadly. So it passes through, this is Trans Australian Highway. This is one road comes up to this region here. These are the iron ore mines passing through this. This is also Northern Highway in Australia. So they cross all the biggest deserts of the world, you know. Great Sandy Desert, Great Victoria Desert, Tanami Desert, Gibson Desert, Simpson Desert. They cross many deserts. This is kind of no man's land, but they passes through. They connect this because here, you know, gold mines are there. Coolgardie and Kalgoorlie are the two important. Because of the exploration of mineral resources, these roads are connected. They have the great significance. So I was talking about the surface. Another type of surface transport is the railways. So railways are basically, we have the different type of railways. So we have the narrow gauge, meter gauge, broad gauge. Nowadays we have the super gauge. Super gauge is a kind of universal gauge throughout the world. Jab desh azad hua tha, sabke har, we had the princely fiefdoms. In those princely kingdoms, we have the different gauges. सबसे बड़ी problem Britishers को जब railway network उसके बाद आया तो सबको unification किया. After independence, maximum investment railway has done on making the unification of gauge कि एक train सब जगह चली जाए. Now we are connecting, one train should go to everywhere in the world, wherever it is the connected by the land. So we have the super gauge is there. Metro is having the super gauge. But we have the Indian Railway is having the broad gauge. There is the minor difference in the gauge. In the gauge means the width of the track to maintain the gravity of the moving vehicle. So this is the railways, and railway is having telescopic freight advantage. With increasing distance, here its initial cost is very high, but shuru mein cost zyada hai, lekin banne ke baad लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस में इसका पर स्क्वायर पर किलोमीटर एक्सपेंसेस कीप डिक्रीजेस. किलोमीटर बढ़ता जाता है तो इसका खर्चा घटता जाता है. सो फॉर लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस दिस इज गुड. फॉर शॉर्ट डिस्टेंस रोड्स आर हैविंग डिफरेंट एडवांटेजेस. रोड्स आर प्रोवाइडिंग एडवांटेज, घर से घर तक पहुँचाता है. इफ यू आर हैविंग स्कूटी, यू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम योर डोर स्टेप एंड यू रीच टू योर कॉलेज. So it is doorstep to doorstep, origin to destination, it provide facility. But railway have the fixed terminals. We have to go to terminal, we take the advantage of road, then only we will reach over there. Then for long distance, this is good. It depends on the nature of the country. If the country is vast, if the country is big, then railway network is the most ideal network for connectivity. For connectivity of the region. So this is basically one mode is the road. Within second mode is the railways, where the different type of rail, I may say 2-3 railway tracks. There is one Trans-Canadian, there is another Trans-Canadian railway line. This moves from Quebec, so say it is from Toronto to Vancouver, Trans-Canadian railway line. Says it is Trans-American railway line is also there. But in America and Canada, it's very surprising. वहाँ का rail transport cost is very high. Train is basically used for goods transport only, not for passenger. क्योंकि उनके पास time कहाँ है. Train takes lot of time for long distance journey. So and they have money to pay, so they can travel fast by air. So but for long distance they have the like Trans-Siberian railway line. I constructed once. You must be knowing Trans-Canadian. Trans-Siberian railway line is the longest railway line in the world. We have the another railway line like that is called Cape Cairo railway line. So though it is non-functional nowadays, it's non-functional means this is Cape. Cape means Cape Town and Cairo. So it is connected by many countries and सब ये कंटिन्यूटी में नहीं है यहाँ टूट जाती है बट दिस इज कनेक्टिंग फ्रॉम केप टाउन टू कैरो इन इजिप्ट सो इट्स द ट्रांस केप कैरो ट्रांस अफ्रीकन रेलवे लाइन सो सच टाइप ऑफ रेलवे ट्रैक्स आर देयर से साइमल्टेनियसली आई मे जस्ट कंस्ट्रक्ट I may simply construct, say, Trans-Siberian railway line. Trans-Siberian railway line, I said it is approximately 9,200 kilometers, one of the longest, starting from the Baltic Sea. Baltic means Atlantic Sea, accessibility to Atlantic. And Baltic very close to polar Arctic Circle, and from Arctic Circle it comes very close to the Caspian Sea. Mediterranean climate it touches, and it moves to the Siberia, very frozen, and reached up to the Pacific coast in Vladivostok. So again, I'm just writing Saint Petersburg. Or you can say Leningrad. Leningrad to Moscow. Can you name six towns on this route? Then another city is called Kazan. Then another city is Magnitogorsk. Then another city is Novosibirsk. Novosibirsk. Siberia to सिबिर्स्क बोलते हैं हम इसको साइबेरिया बोलते हैं देन इट इज क्रास्नोयार्स्क और हम इसको नोवोकुज़्नेत्स्क बोल सकते हैं नोवोकुज़्नेत्स्क यहाँ सब जगह आयरन एंड स्टील इंडस्ट्री और हैवी इंजीनियरिंग इंडस्ट्री की मैंने बात की थी देन इट इज इरकुटस्क इन ऑन लेक बाइकाल देन इट इज ए सिटी कॉल्ड चिटा Then it is from Chita to it comes all the way up to Vladivostok. Vladivostok. So it is all trans such a long connecting from this is facing the Baltic and this is Baltic means at Pacific and it is Atlantic to Pacific. Vladivostok is on Pacific. So these are the transcontinental. Railway tracks, we have the short railway tracks, as short as the metro, you have 10 kilometer tracks sometimes, sometimes you have 2 kilometer tracks, and these are thousands of kilometer long tracks passing through the different conditions, because railway is providing all weather conditions, like even in India, government of India is trying their level best to connect Srinagar to Jammu, because Srinagar Jammu have the only reliable connectivity, air is not affordable for heavy goods and all the time for transporting the apple and all the horticultural products, air cannot be used, it's very costly, poor people cannot rely on this. So in Srinagar Valley, from Jammu to Srinagar, we have to cross the Pir Panjal mountain range. Pir Panjal means Lesser Himalayas. Lesser Himalayas, just quickly, I'm just making a small sketch. Small sketch is, this is the plain, this is the Sivalik, and this is, and it is like this. So this is Jammu here. This side is the Jammu. We cross Jammu and this is say Udhampur. Udhampur is the Dun. This is Siwalik. This is Lesser Himalaya and this is the Greater Himalaya. This is Greater Himalaya. So Siwalik is Udhampur Dun. देहरादून कोटलीदून पाटलीदून कटरादून जब वैष्णो देवी पे चढ़ाई करते हैं कटरा से करते हैं ना दून पे सो हियर दिस इज लेसर हिमालय इन कश्मीर इज नोन एज पीर पंजाल सो इट इज दिस इज वी आर कनेक्टिंग टनल्स वी आर दिस रूट इज पासिंग थ्रू the very rugged terrains means undulated topography. This landmass is highly fractured, this landmass is highly ruptured, this landmass is highly folded. Sometimes you know the disaster possibility if this is the mountain range, if there is the bedding plane, sometimes if it is the bedding planes are like this, layers of the sedimentation is like this. It means this area is prone to landslide because this bedding plane and this bedding plane, this linear zone is where two different sediments are layer. This is the weaker zone. हो सकता है heavy mass आए तो ये सारा का सारा इस line से ऐसे slide कर जाए. So this area is prone to landslide. But if we construct road here, this there will be possibility that landslide will not take place. But if we cut it from here, and it means there is the great possibility that this landmass may slide down. So it is basically the inclination. So that's why this Peer Panchal is highly fractured, ruptured, compressed, unorganized, weaker rocks, because this is the youngest formation of mountains. अभी अपलिफ्टमेंट हुआ है अभी मीन्स रॉक्स आर नॉट प्रॉपरली लिथिफाइड दे आर नॉट हार्ड एनफ सो दैट्स व्हाई दिस रेलवे लाइन इज डिफिकल्ट टू कंस्ट्रक्ट देयर आर सो मेनी टनल्स करते हैं बट आफ्टर द कंस्ट्रक्शन बिकॉज श्रीनगर इज हियर इन द वैली सो दिस इज द श्रीनगर वे श्रीनगर वैली इफ इट विल बी कनेक्टेड द इकोनॉमी बिकॉज श्रीनगर इज द सिटी विच इज डाइसेक्टेड फ्रॉम रेस्ट ऑफ द कंट्री फॉर 4 मंथ्स अगर रेलवे से हो जाए तो क्या होगा इट विल बी कनेक्टेड टू द रेस्ट ऑफ द कंट्री राउंड द ईयर देयर इकोनॉमी विल बूस्ट दे विल फाइंड एम्प्लॉयमेंट ऑलमोस्ट हाफ ऑफ द ईयर द पीपल रिमेन अनएम्प्लॉयड सो दैट्स व्हाई दे आर ओनली रेल देयर इज द पॉसिबिलिटी दैट रेल कनेक्टिविटी विल प्रोवाइड द इंक्रीज द बूस्ट द इकोनॉमी ऑफ द रीजन साइमल्टेनियसली वी हैव अनदर प्लान टू कनेक्ट द लेह सिटी Leh Ladakh, Trans Himalayas. We are planning to connect Trans Himalayas with the railway network. Though we have the railway line up to Joginder Nagar in Mandi district from Pathankot to Joginder Nagar, that is the meter gauge. Meter gauge is like this small track is there. But we are planning to connect the same, extend the same track up to Leh city. So Leh would be connected from rest of the country round the year. So these railways are the important modes of transportation for long distance, for bulky material and for cheapest cost. Though its installation and initial cost is high, but later it is the its cost is cheaper in comparison to road transport. Road se यहाँ से बेंगलोर सामान ट्रक से भेजेंगे और यहाँ से बेंगलोर सामान ट्रेन से भेजेंगे एक ट्रक में तो क्या होगा रोड कॉस्ट वुड बी ऑलमोस्ट 5 times हायर देन द रेल कॉस्ट सो इट मीन्स फॉर लॉन्गर डिस्टेंस इट इज़ गुड बट अगर दिल्ली से अगर हमें जयपुर सामान भेजना है या जयपुर से छोड़ो अगर रेवाड़ी सामान भेजना है सो इट इज़ गुड टू सेंड बाई रोड फॉर शॉर्ट डिस्टेंस इट इज़ गुड बिकॉज वी विल बी एबल टू ओवरकम द टर्मिनल चार्जेस और ट्रेन का यहाँ से ट्रेन्स आर नॉट प्रोवाइडिंग डोर टू डोर फैसिलिटी रोड प्रोवाइड्स डोर टू डोर फैसिलिटी फॉर लॉन्ग शॉर्ट डिस्टेंस वी प्रेफर रोड ट्रांसपोर्ट फॉर लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस वी प्रेफर रेलवे नेटवर्क सो अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट द थर्ड मोड ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इज द नेविगेशन वाटरवेज
third mode of transport is the waterways.
Waterways, there are the two type of waterways. One is the inland waterways, and the marine waterways, marine navigation. So marine navigation, so there is the great inland waterways. Like even in India we have the National Waterway Authority, and they have also divided National Waterway number 1, Waterway number 1 from Kolkata to Allahabad to Haldia, Kolkata to Haldia. Haldia is 300 km facing the sea on the mouth of Hooghly, because Hooghly connects by the canal and by the Ganga river, and that Ganga reaches up to Allahabad. Waterway number 2 from Sadia to Dhubri, that is Brahmaputra river. Sadia is on Bangladesh border and Dhubri is on the upper side, very close to Dhubri is in the upper Assam, very close to you can say Arunachal Pradesh foothills, when the Brahmaputra enters into the plain. So we have waterway backwaters, we have the backwaters, we have the Buckingham Canal. I mentioned earlier Buckingham Canal in Andhra Pradesh. We have the backwaters in Kerala. They are also known as Kayals, Vembanad Kayal, Ashtamudi Kayal, Sastamkotta Kayal. The backwaters they provide. Backwaters are the lifeline of Kerala. They are the source of to maintain the ecosystem. They provide water for agriculture. They are the source of fishing activities. Machli wahan milti hai. Pani wahan milta hai agriculture ke liye. So that maintain the entire ecosystem, the backwaters. So most of the rivers, before entering into the sea, they run parallel to the coast, and that provide that water expands like anything. It's a quite wide channel, and that developed a wetland. So those inland waterways, they provide, like I mentioned the name, Welland Canal in Canada, which connects Lake Ontario to Lake Erie to bypass the Niagara Fall. I also mentioned Mittelland Canal is in Germany, which connects industrial region of Germany. Industrial region of Germany means it connects all the Ruhr Basin and all the up to the end industrial level we can supply the product. So Welland Canal, all the industrial towns, I can say Duisburg, Dortmund, Dusseldorf, Krefeld, Bremen, so many cities are industrial. Essen is the largest steel plant of Germany, one of the most industrialized country, and engineering the country which is the torchbearer of the engineering industry in the world. So it is the Welland Canal that provides the magic of transport in that region. Sari duniya mein industrialization coastal region pe hota hai. Interior mein isliye sambhav hua, it was possible because they had the Welland Canal. Apart from that, we connected some of the big oceans and the seas, like Panama Canal, you know, this is in South America. This is Atlantic, this is Pacific, and we constructed a canal here. So what happened, this is the Panama Canal. So this yahan se agar idhar jana hai ship ko to iska chakkar lagana padta tha. It was almost 10,000 km extra journey. When we constructed it, it is easy, it reduced 10,000 km journey, so much of costly and expensive and time consuming. So it increased, it gave boost. Ab to aisa hai, Gulf Coastal Industrial Region is very close to the Pacific Industrial Region of USA. San Francisco, say,